Ben Nemchik is the conductor of the Westchester Oratorio Society. Thank you for joining us today, and congratulations for the 16th birthday celebration. There are a lot of wonderful events that are going on and that you are organizing. What can we look forward to in the future?
First of all, it's an amazing season for Westchester Oratorio Society. Not just 15 years of success, and we know that in the art world, you know, a year is like 100 years. I mean, if you can survive year after year, you're doing pretty well. And Westchester Oratorio has been very fortunate to have existed for this long, and not only to exist for 15, 16 years, but also to thrive. And that's the great thing about this group. The thing that I love is that they take the music seriously, but they have fun. And they have events like these, usually in the fall and the spring, these little soirées, as we like to call them, where we get together, and regardless of the birthday or the age, we treat it like it's like a birthday party. It's like a celebration, a coming together of people in a setting that we normally wouldn't experience in a chorus. You know, chorus is a lot of sort of regimented, sitting down, singing the right notes, watching the conductor. These are an opportunity, these events, to really kind of kick back and to get to know one another in a place different from the choral, you know, the choral risers.
And it seems like everyone had a lot of fun today. What other events are going on recently that we can look forward to?
Well, this is the biggest year Westchester Oratorio Society has ever planned. We have more than 7 events. Compared to some organizations, that's not a lot of events, but for Westchester Oratorio, it just about doubles the number of endeavors that we take on each year. We have a fall concert, which is coming up on November the 18th at Temple Shere Tefila. That's not too far from Bedford, actually, and it's at that place and time, Sunday, November 18th, when we'll perform Schoenberg's Survivor from Warsaw, which is a dramatic telling of a Holocaust survivor. And that's paired with the Brahms Requiem. And for people who know the Requiem, they know that it's not a mass for the dead like is traditionally done in music, but it's really a mass for the living. You know, give comfort to us, those who mourn. So that's coming up in November. In December, we have our annual gig at Muscoot Farm, and that's great. Over in Somers, we get together at the Muscoot Farm, we sing some holiday tunes, get to eat all homemade cookies and brownies and apple cider and stuff like that, so it's a lot of fun. Then 2013 rolls around, and we really just go for it with a performance at the Chappaqua Library in March. We also have a January small fundraiser, and then our big concert, really one of the biggest concerts that we've ever given, is going to take place on Sunday, June the 2nd, and that is the Westchester Oratorio Society's debut with the great French pianist Hélène Grimaud. Now, for those who don't know about Hélène Grimaud is a world-known pianist. You can find her on YouTube playing at the BBC proms, all the great music halls of the world. She also actually is a resident of Westchester, and in her spare time does a lot of fundraising events for the Wolf Conservation Fund. So this event with Westchester Oratorio is in conjunction with the Wolf Conservation Fund, and we're going to present one of her best pieces, the Beethoven Choral Fantasy. Now also this concert, it's not just a benefit for Wolf Conservation, it's also a tribute to one of the founders of Westchester Oratorio Society, Bob McDonald, who was both involved with the Oratorio Society and the Wolf Center. So we have a lot of efforts kind of coming together in one place, and we get to perform with a pianist like Hélène Grimaud. And if one has ever performed with a great virtuoso, you know that it's an event like none other. It's just an absolute thrill. So there's a lot of stuff going on with Westchester Oratorio. You know, we hope people will come out to our concerts, visit the website, westchesteroratorio.org. Again, westchesteroratorio.org. And if you sing, you want to be a part of a group, but you don't want to audition for an ensemble, there's no audition. Come on out, come to our website, and we can work that out.
Thank you, Ben.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm Amanda Kiss, reporting for LCTV, accompanied by pianist and composer John Rose and highly acclaimed vocalist Sing Rose. Thank you so much for joining us today. You just performed here at St. Matthew's, and it was absolutely magical. The audience was truly captivated, and we are thrilled to have had the opportunity to experience your talent locally, right here in Bedford. Now, with a name like Sing, you were destined to be a soprano. Where did your love for music originate from?
My family, there's a lot of singers, including my mom, and then my two aunts, and then my cousin, and me. So we all opera singers, and then my mom's singing all the time, opera, and then I heard a lot. Just like my baby's listening, my singing, that's inspired me a lot of things. And then I know what I have to do when I see my mom's performance. And I learned, oh, that's good things to do. That's not good things to do. So it's a lot of from that experience, I learned a lot. And then the talent came from there.
Clearly the talent runs in your family then. And John, what inspires you to compose music?
Usually it's a story. And a lot of time will actually go by between compositions. Typically I'll either read a great book or think of something that I find inspiring that I would like to share with other people. And so typically it would be either a children's story or something that I find very memorable.
Okay, that's wonderful. And this past May, you just came back from a collaboration with the Dubrovnik Philharmonic Orchestra in Europe. What was that experience like for both of you?
Playing with a wonderful orchestra is just such a wonderful feeling. It's when we perform, when I sing, behind the orchestra sounds come out. It's like ocean covering me. It's just wonderful. I just love to perform with orchestra. It's great. Dubrovnik was wonderful. Yeah, the orchestra really good, has good sound. And then conductor was wonderful, very nice. And then so we have a very good experience from it.
And John, your compositions were featured with the orchestra. What was that like?
It was like a dream come true. The conductor in Europe affiliated with that orchestra had submitted them, and the symphony orchestra was very interested. And so, you know, first of all, we flew to this historic city. It's a walled city, and it's more than 1,000 years old and already beautiful. And yet under those circumstances, I got to meet and listen to this orchestra rehearse the music and perform it. And so for me, it's just like Singh was saying, it's a rush. You're almost speechless.
And October is a very exciting month for the both of you. Can you tell us a little bit about Rumpelstiltskin?
Yes. It was during a different trip, a trip when we performed in Ukraine with the conductor. After our concert, we had this idea already to do an opera. And the as I mentioned before, what inspires me to compose, well, this was my favorite story when I was a child. And I have a book that was illustrated by Edward Gorey, the illustrator. And it seemed to me like the natural story to put to music. It's filled with drama. It's a wonderful comeuppance story. You've got really clear good versus evil. And it captivates, I think, not just children, but families. Because I really believe that music should be shared with people of all ages. So that's what this opera does. In an hour and 20 minutes, you have the whole spectrum of feelings and actions and emotions. And the libretto actually was written by another Connecticut resident as well. So we've got a lot of our local talent involved in this project.
And I'm sure a lot of viewers are very interested in going to see the opera. What theater is it going to be performed at?
The theater is Opera America, National Opera Center. It's on 7th Avenue and I believe 29th Street.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today. It has been a pleasure speaking with you, and it was even more of a pleasure to actually watch you perform. Thank you.
You're watching Lewisboro Community Television, Channel 20.